Back in high school, I worked out the various geometries of various geodesic domes, and I even made a 60-sided one out of wood. The 60-sided one is essentially a dodecahedron, and instead of making it a flat pentagon, each pentagon is made out of five triangles to give it a peak. And then the pentagons fit together like so. This time around, I worked it out in CAD, and I'm going to need to make 60 of these triangles with the edges beveled 8.95 and 13.1 degrees. And I'm going to cut these from these boards from an old futon frame, and these aren't entirely straight, so I have to cut them to shorter pieces before I start making triangles. The triangles are going to come out of the board like this, and then like this, and then like this. And so I might as well bevel the one edge to this bevel here, and that bevel is going to be slanted this way. And then for the next piece, the bevel is actually facing down. I drew my bevel angle in CAD, and this is on a square, and I printed that, again rotated 90 degrees so I can make sure my printout has no distortion. So holding this one on top of the other one, rotate it 90 degrees, I can see the square lines up perfectly. Close enough. I just set the miter gauge to the angle of the triangle, and I'm using the paper printout against a fence to check that. And the blade tilt changes to 13.12 degrees. So just by flipping this workpiece over between cuts, I can get all the bevels correctly. So it turns out after making a cut to get one of these triangles off, I actually have this corner missing. So I shaped the stop in such a way that after making that cut, I can just push it against here and make another cut so you can get a crisp corner. So with all these cuts, I figured there's quite a risk of maybe cutting into my hand by accident. And I thought a saw stop would be handy, but I'm actually kind of glad I don't have a saw stop because I cut into my clamp right here, and I sure would be cursing right now if I had a saw stop. So let's see how these triangles fit together. Yeah, that works out. So here's my 12 pentagons, and let's see how those all fit together. I may have some slight gaps here. Maybe I'll tweak these a bit with a hand plane. Well, a little improved. It's tempting to just let the glue dry on what I've got so far, but every time I add a panel in, I may have to warp what's there a little bit to make it fit better, so I'm better off working with the glue still wet. I'm not going to glue the last one in place because I still want to be able to get into it. To some extent, building one of these things is kind of miters from hell. You can't tell if it's going to fit together until you actually do put it together, and I have a few gaps in some of the joints on this thing. But I figure even with the gaps, it should still be able to hold my weight, so let's give that a shot. Oh yeah, no problem.